गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास 11th, सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री, चैप्टर 5, स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर एंड लेक्चर नंबर 4. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट होमवर्क ऑफ लेक्चर नंबर 3. सो आई गेव यू क्वेश्चन नंबर 16. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 16, पेलोड इज डिफाइंड एज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द मास ऑफ डिस्प्लेस्ड एयर एंड द मास ऑफ द बलून. ओके, बिकॉज इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट पेलोड. दैट इज वाई पेलोड इज डिफाइंड हियर. Difference between mass of the displaced air and the mass of the balloon. Calculate the payload when a balloon of radius 10 meter, mass 100 kg, is filled with helium at 1.66 bar at 27 degree Celsius. Density of air is given and value of gas constant is also given. Now, according to the definition of payload, we have to write difference between the mass of the displaced air. Now, mass of the displaced air can be calculated using formula volume into density. So, look here. Maximum mass of the air that can be displaced by balloon to go up is volume into density. Density is given in the question, and volume of the balloon we can calculate by the radius. Radius of the balloon is given 10 meter. Formula is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So from this formula we can determine volume of the balloon. Put the value here, and the volume is equal to 4190.5 meter cube. So here, if you will put the value of volume, and density is given in the question 1.2 kilogram meter per cube, then it is equal to 5028.6. That means here in the definition the mass of the displaced air, now it is known. Second thing is mass of the balloon. Now we have to find out mass of the balloon with the gas, because mass of balloon is given, that is 100 kg. But we have to find out mass of the balloon with gas. Okay. So here helium gas is filled in the balloon. So volume of helium gas filled at 1.66 bar and 27 degree Celsius is equal to 4190.5 meter cube, because this is the volume of balloon. We want to find out what is the mass of helium gas inside the balloon. Okay, so here we will use the formula PV is equal to nRT. N is number of moles, so we can write given mass divided by molecular mass. Here we want to find out value of W. What is the mass of helium gas? Okay, so shift all the other quantities on the side. Then the formula will become W is equal to MPV divided by RT. Here M is molecular mass of helium gas. So it is 4. Here we have to convert gram into kilogram. So into 10 to the power minus 3. Pressure is given, that is 1.66 bar. Okay. Value of V is this, 4190.5 meter cube. Here we have to convert meter cube into decimeter cube, because value gas constant is given and here the volume is in decimeter cube. So that is why we have to convert volume into decimeter cube. Divided by R into T, temperature will be in Kelvin. When you will solve this, it will comes equal to 1117.5 kg. So this is a mass of helium gas. Now mass of balloon is 100 kg. Now, this much helium is filled in the balloon. Now, you have to add these two. Okay. So, here 100 plus 1117.5 is equal to 1217.5 kilogram. That is the total mass of the balloon along with helium gas. Okay. Now, according to definition of payload, difference between the mass of displaced air and the mass of the balloon. So now both the things are known. So here we will put the value. Okay, 5028.6, which is the maximum mass of the air that can be displaced by balloon to go up, and mass of the balloon along with helium is 1217.5 kg. It is equal to 3811.1 kilogram. So this is the payload. Now next question is, Calculate the volume occupied by 8.8 gram of carbon dioxide at 31.1 degree Celsius and 1 bar pressure. Value of gas constant is given 0.083 bar liter Kelvin inverse mole inverse. We have to find out volume. So we will use ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT. N is given mass divided by molecular mass. So here all the things are known except volume. Okay, so you have to shift pressure in the denominator and put all the values. So first we will find out value of N, that is mass of CO2 divided by molar mass. So 8.8 divided by 44 is equal to 0.2 mole. Now put the values in this formula. It is equal to 5.048 liter. Now question number 18. 2.9 gram of a gas at 95 degrees Celsius occupied the same volume as 0.184 gram of hydrogen at 17 degrees Celsius at the same pressure. What is the molar mass of the gas? So here volume and pressure both are equal, right? So P1 is equal to P2 and V1 is equal to V2, because in question it is given that same volume and same pressure. So formula is PV is equal to nRT, right? Now P1 is equal to P2, V1 is equal to V2. So when we write this equation, then we can say that P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Okay, so both the quantities are equal. So here we can write N1 RT1 is equal to N2 RT2, because here temperature are different and number of moles are also different. Value of R is same for both. So here R will be cancelled out and it will be N1T1 is equal to N2T2. Now we can write number of moles like in this way. Given mass divided by molar mass into T1 is equal to given mass divided by molar mass into T2. Now W1 is 2.9. Here you can see that, right? And we have to find out value of M1 into temperature is 95 degrees Celsius. So we will convert it into Kelvin. So plus 273. Here also given mass is 0.184 gram. Molar mass is 2 because it is hydrogen gas, H2 gas. So temperature is 17 degrees. So we will convert it into Kelvin. So value of M1 will come is equal to 40 gram per mole. So this is question number 18. I am repeating it again. Equation is P1 V1 is equal to N1 RT1. Okay. For second gas, it will be P2 V2 is equal to N2 RT2. Now P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So this will be cancelled out. And here we will compare these two. Okay. Now question number 19, a mixture of dihydrogen and dioxygen at 1 bar pressure contains 20% by weight of a dihydrogen. Calculate the partial pressure of dihydrogen. Now 20% by weight of dihydrogen means that 20 gram hydrogen is present and oxygen is present 80 gram. How? Because 20 gram hydrogen is present in total 100 gram solution. Okay, so total solution is 100 gram. So 100 minus 20, it is equal to 80. That means 80 gram dioxygen is present. Now, you can find out number of moles of hydrogen and oxygen. Why we are calculating number of moles? Because we will apply formula partial pressure of gas is equal to mole fraction of that gas into total pressure. So using this formula, we can find out partial pressure of the gas. So here we want to find out partial pressure of dihydrogen gas. Okay, so we need mole fraction, and mole fraction formula is number of moles of hydrogen divided by total number of moles of all the gases present in solution. So number of moles of hydrogen is equal to 20 by 2 because amount of hydrogen is 20 gram. Because it is present 20%. So 20 divided by molar mass of hydrogen, because atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 and H2 gas is there. So 20 by 2 is equal to 10 moles. In the same way, we can find out number of moles of oxygen. So here given mass is 80 and molecular mass of dioxygen is 32. It is equal to 2.5 moles. Now put the values in the formula and it will comes equal to 0.8 bar. This is question number 19. Now question number 21. In terms of Charles' law, explain why minus 273 degrees Celsius is the lowest possible temperature. Because at minus 273 degrees Celsius temperature, volume of the gas becomes equal to zero. That means gas does not exist at that temperature. So this is a hypothetical temperature. That is why minus 273 degrees Celsius is the lowest possible temperature. Question number 23. Explain the physical significance of van der Waals parameter. When you will write van der Waals equation, then in that equation we use A and B parameters. Now what are those A and B parameters? So A is the measure of the magnitude of the intermolecular forces of attraction, while B is the measure of the effective size of the gas molecules. This is measure, correct? If you have any doubt or queries, you can ask me on my email ID. Thank you and have a nice day.